How should I take zinc if it makes me nauseous?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Hey, Chris, how are you?
Good. How you doing?
Good, man. I appreciate you taking the time. So I'm new to all of your Masterpass, all that stuff. I've been going through some things. I kind of have a two-part question, mainly regards some of the things that we've been trying to work on, specifically with my wife. So her and I have both been taking a zinc supplement, the Jaro formula, the one that you've recommended. And I mean, when I take it, I can take it in the morning at, you know, probably 11, 12 hours into like a 13-hour, 14, 16-hour restricted window. At the beginning, you know, I would get a little nauseous, but I'm okay now. If she takes it, she takes it in the morning. I mean, it's brutal. Like, I mean, it completely just knocks her down. And I guess my first question was, is there a direct correlation between nausea and zinc deficiency? So if she's extremely nauseous from it and I'm not, does that indicate that she's dealing with a higher level of a zinc deficiency? And if so, what's the process? Does she just have to suck it up and work through it and build up a tolerance? Or is there a different approach that has to be taken for her to supplement with the zinc?
What dose is it?
15 milligram.
Just a 15, one capsule. As far as I know, there's no relationship between the nausea and zinc deficiency. I could be wrong. Maybe there's research on it I haven't seen, or it could be under, you know, not researched, but I don't think there's a connection. My guess would be that that is either related to her ionizing it faster in the GI tract than you, or, or, you know, something else related to her nausea impulse that might be nutritional, might be genetic, might be, you know, male, female. So I don't know what it is, but I don't think it is related to zinc deficiency. And I don't think it's something that she should have to power through either. So okay. Basically, if it's making you, so 15 milligrams, 1.5 milligrams of zinc generally doesn't make most people nauseated, but it makes some people nauseated. And if it makes you nauseated, then I think what you want to do is either take a little bit of, you could test out whether like a little bit of bone broth or orange juice or what have you with it buffers that enough to stop the nausea. And if it doesn't, I would just try to take it with a phytate-free meal. And by a phytate-free meal, I mean a meal that doesn't have any whole grains, nuts, seeds, or legumes. So the rationale for having it on an empty stomach is decent, but it's nowhere near as strong as the rationale for not having it with phytate. And so, it's controversial whether you're going to get a beneficial effect of having it on an empty stomach versus a phytate-free meal, because generally the research when it promoted empty stomach was not versus a phytate-free meal. So that controversy is around, well, maybe that's just because there was phytate in the meal. So, you know, at the end of the day, if 15 milligrams of zinc makes you nauseated, just take it with a phytate-free meal.
Okay, I got that. And the second part of that, apologize about the background noise. You're getting a lot of snow up here, so
that's fine.
You're just plowing. I came across when I was doing some further research an article that was labeled "Studies on the bioavailability of zinc in humans: effects on heme and non-heme iron on the absorption of zinc." So she's also, she's anemic, and she's been taking 35 milligrams of an iron bisglycinate for probably 8-9 months now. And we took it by itself. We also took the thorn formula, the Ferrazorb, that I think has vitamin C and has folate in it as well. The iron doesn't seem to bother her stomach or anything like that, but Is there any possible association with the iron supplementation and the zinc for the efficacy of the zinc for her as well? Because the article was saying something around 35 milligrams can inhibit the amount of zinc being absorbed. Now, I don't know if that was something where she had to take them at different times or if she shouldn't be taking them together at all.
I would not take them at the same meal.
Okay.
Just to be on the safe side.
Okay. Perfect. Perfect. Awesome. Yeah. Those are my questions. Right. I appreciate it, Chris. Cool. Thanks.
Thank you. Take care. Good to meet you.
You as well.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Masterpass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.